Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism, here rendering an exposition of Matthew 5, the Sermon on the Mount, which are beatitudes, or purpose for which Christ Jesus came. So he defines it over here. And I was doing about the sins and other thing that is connected with the moral laws. Transgression against the moral law is a sin, while, transgression against the Holy Spirit is a blasphemy. So in Jesus, sin carries no weight, but blasphemy. So if you are not what is you inside and what you are outside, then you are a hypocrite. And hypocrites are not welcome into the churches, nor the sinners. So sins are normally committed by children because they do so under ignorance. So when you are grown up, then you don't commit sin. Then you do it knowingly. So that's why Peter, those people who sold their property, Ananias and Sapphira, and they told a lie to the Peter, lie mean a sin, he did not entertain them into the church. He only entertained those people who fulfilled the law. So if you haven't fulfilled the law, you are a sinner, you cannot enter into the church. So the church is not for the youngster also, because in Jesus, you have to learn the spiritual principles which are for the adults. So that's why the people who are baptized at the age of 20 to 25 to 30 or so, only church is for those people and not for those children who are put in creche and all that. A youngster, you know, who go there. And it's not for them, but being this organization of Mammon, nobody cares. So the person who should be entering the church, he is supposed to make himself more righteous than these rabbis and Pharisee and Sadducee, or he need to be more righteous than John the Baptist. As Christ Jesus said, the least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. So you have to be righteous in Jesus. Otherwise you can't take part in the Jesus. So when you are a righteous person, then you are called Son of God, because God is righteous. But when you are not righteous, because you remember that the royal kingdom of heaven is not as good as the royal kingdom of God. Royal kingdom of God is far superior to the kingdom of heaven. In the kingdom of heaven, there are corruptions, while in the royal kingdom of God, which is in your heart, it is corruption free. It's only corruption free when your heart is clean. Your heart is righteous. And that's why Jesus stressed, you know, as the royal kingdom of God is greater than the kingdom of heaven. So your righteousness should also surpass those of the Pharisee and Sadducee, are the moral teachers, so much so that even you surpass John the Baptist, Prophet Elijah, or the ideal rabbi. So, person when he is righteous, then he is in God, because God stands for righteousness. But if you become unrighteous and you get start doing favors to this and that because of your same color or some other thing that tempt you, that he is a member of the Freemason and I'm also a Freemason, let's do favor to each other as they do it. So they have special language and all that, and when they meet each other, they create signs identifying themselves. And when the person who is judging, then he will do them the favor. So what happens when somebody does the favor? As it is in racism, racist people do and all that, that you have become unrighteous. You have taken somebody's right, given to the other. So when you become unrighteous, unrighteous is Satan, not God. The enemy of God is Satan. So you have joined the forces of Satan. You may go to the church, that doesn't make any difference, because you are a liar and not, your heart is not like little children, what is inside and outside. You are hypocrites. So hypocrites are not welcome into the churches. So that's why Saint Peter created a good atmosphere in the church, that only the adult who fulfill the law, that means they don't tell lies, they don't cheat anybody, and they don't murder, and all that 10 commandments of Moses. If they obey those 10 commandments, then they can enter into the church of God. So that's why Jesus said, I have come to fulfill the law and not to destroy it. When your house is built upon the 10 commandments of Moses, then your house is built on rock. That water mean people who come to test you, that hey, this man is a liar, then you can defend it, you know, that I haven't cheated anybody. Remember how Matthew, when he was taken into the workforce of Christ Jesus, and the other people, you know, overlooking, was saying, hey, this man eating with the sinners, and all that nonsense they were talking. Then Matthew stood up and said, if I owe anybody any money, let him point it out now, and I will pay 7 times what I owe him. So when he openly declared it, nobody dared to point a finger at him, because he was a righteous person. So such a person only can become the workers of Christ Jesus. And as I explained earlier, the people of Judah tribe, this dark age belonged to the people of Judah tribe. They live in Judea region, concentrated there. So it was the people of Judea region who were the most satanic people. And they pushed the apostles out of their churches. When they brought the written Torah into the churches, which was corrupt, and they were reading that written Torah by the letters without understanding. So when the apostle used to come, they used to rebuke them, you know, that what the hell you are doing? You are reading written Torah with all those holes in it. Can't you mend them? Can't you darn them? They could not, because they have become greedy and they have started to love mammon more than God. So the God took the sense to understand his word away from them. Remember, only you get his word in your heart if you clean your heart, make it suitable for him, Christ, to enter into your heart. If Christ is not in your heart, you can't preach gospel. Thank you.